Greetings, everyone. My name is Pichi Shiviri, a PhD candidate from the University of Limpopo, and I'll be giving a micro talk titled Monitoring the Structural Changes in Lithium Diffusion Rate on LiMNO Nanoporous Materials During the Discharge Process, under the supervision of Prof. R.S. Lidwaba and Prof. P.E. Mwepe. Previous studies have revealed that the major setback in lithium-ion batteries is caused by the loss in specific capacity, which emanate from inherent materials properties such as low diffusion of lithium ions in the cathodes, hampering their commercial applications. Researchers have therefore centered much attention to the enhancement of spinel LiMN2O4 for constant energy supply and storage due to their good structural stability with improved safety conditions and excellent rate performance with 3D lithium diffusion channels. Porous structures at the nanoscales have been studied and found to shorten the lithium ion diffusion length between the electrolyte and the electrode. Therefore, they can provide a light surface area and pore volume for better interaction with the electrolyte and ionic diffusion, leading to enhanced electrochemical performance and mechanical stability. In this work, we simulate the discharge process of nanoporous materials by employing the amorphization and recrystallization technique to investigate their structural changes and lithium diffusion rate at different lithium concentrations. Simulated amorphization and recrystallization technique based on molecular dynamics using the DL pole code and the bond model of ionic solids were employed to amorphize and recrystallize three LiMNO nanoporous structures of lattice sizes 75, 69, and 67 at different lithium concentrations, where the NVE ensemble was used for amorphization, NPT for atom aggregation, NVT for recrystallization, and the NST for compression. The structural changes observed on the materials after the amorphization and recrystallization processes, amongst others, is the pore size effect, where increasing the lithium concentration from the pristine spinel to Li1.75 resulted in the pore reducing in size for nanoporous 75 with green boundaries and black dotted lines, whereas for nanoporous 69 and 67, the pores completely closed up. However, all the structures regained their original pore size upon full lithiation at Li2.00Mn2O4 concentration. Note that the structures undergo a phase transition at the critical concentration of Li1.75 from cubic to tetragonal spinel phase. Volume analysis on the structures shows resilience to expansion for nanoporous 69 at the critical concentration of Li1.75. Further observations on the structures show that the spinel MN3O4 content gets reduced with increasing lithium concentration, resulting in Mn2 plus atoms retaining the tetrahedral tunnels and also providing channels for lithium diffusion. The diffusion rate of the structures is observed to be higher for nanoporous 75, followed by 69, then 67 for all concentrations, indicating that porosity of materials influences their diffusion rate. In summary, the amorphization and recrystallization technique was used to simulate the discharge process of the LiMNO nanoporous structures with different lattice dimensions and concentrations. Structural changes at the critical concentrations of Li1.75 where the nanoporous 67 is resilient to volume expansion and evolved into a single grain was observed. The porosity of materials was found to influence their diffusion rate. Nanoporous 69 shows more desirable characteristics compared to its counterparts, which might possibly result in an electrode material that can restrain current battery damage by improving the electrochemical and mechanical properties of lithium-ion batteries. And the HPC content, its job calculation begins execution and is complete using 24 CPUs, 24 MPI processes, and the wall time of 48 hours on a normal node under the Lingau cluster using the DL pole code. I would like to acknowledge MMC, NRF, the University of Limpopo, and CHPC for this wonderful platform. Thank you.